Me and Liverpool visited a bar recently and purchased two beers. Bar in question is Dead Crafter, just near the ship metro. So I purchased these two beers from Brewski. One is a collaboration with a friend of mine, Sam Martin. The Red Little Craft Beer, Stone Cross IPA. And the other one is the Coffee Snow Juice. Let's try that. Coffee Snow Juice. So, I'm hoping to try these beers. Did pay an extra price, but they did speculate why it was such a pricey pair of beers. In total, paid £15 sterling. Pause. The only justification I have for purchasing these two beers for £15 is I'm on holiday. It's still £15 for two beers, £15. Is that justification? But you have to remember that it's the distribution you're paying for, the quality of ingredients, and the region that these beers come from. So you basically weigh a lot in. And I'm kind of trying to justify the price. But let's crack your beers open. Let's have a look. So, this is a microbrewery. Let's look at the branding. Helsingborg. So, I've got. Look at the view on them. So. Stone Cross was 6.5%. It's a collaboration with. Oh, okay. Has now become something of a cult expression within the craft beer world. Being YouTube's vlogger, Sam Martin's go to expression when stumbling upon a beer he likes. But yeah, let's look. So this is Stone Cross. It does smell good though, in fairness. I have had some Brewski beers before. Oh, it just felt really. Cheers. That's not bad. £7.50? I don't know. You do get lots of beautiful fruits. Almost like you're crunching between your palate. It's a nice beer. I can't remember Sam's vlog on this though. But I'm sure it will really exaggerated. But it's Brewski. An Alefarm Brewing, apparently. Expires 16th of 11, 2018. Weighs in at 6.5%. Beautiful artwork, as always. All Brewski beers. We read and watch you and publish the Uttermost. Ryan is such an amazing man. But yeah. Nice little spiel on the side. Pause. So let's crack on to the next beer. So this beer, I only purchased this because it has a pug on it, and it's cool. A dog with a coffee mug. This is 11.5% beer. Now, you've got the second thing. These two beers, but the same price. One, an 11.5% Imperial. What meal style, I think? And the other one was a collaboration between three things, Brewski, Alefarm Brewing, and St. Martin. Anyway, so, on to the coffee snoot juice. Novices love like cold, wet mucus from your best friend's snout. So, this is our tribute to our copper neighbours that keep the building smelling great. All I'm still trying to figure out why I paid £15 for 2 years. But so far, 1 out of 2 is good beer. So this is colour is very dark, 11.5%. Do get elements of coffee. Holy shit, Jesus. Very alcoholic on the palate. Strong hints of licorice and not salt. Prunes. Different prunes. I've noticed all the beers from Brewski are very potent on the fruit. Which is good because it just shows that the amount of passion that goes into the beer. Now, let's take a look at the thing. I paid £15 for these two beers. Are they worth the £15 that I paid? It's drinking two beers in my apartment here in Liverpool. Ah well, I'm an older. Money didn't last forever. But anyway, would I recommend these beers to others? Yeah, they are really good beers, but hopefully you could manage to find them a lot better price than I did. But anyway, nice collaboration here with three people, Brewski, Alefarm, and St. Martin. This is almost like a tribute, but collaborations to an extent. But nice elements for 11.5% beer. Beautiful artwork on all the Brewski beers. Definitely recommend. You take care. And if you are on a hill trail, pause, reflect, and think. Should I be buying that beer, or should I wait until I see it a lot cheaper? You take care. Goodbye.